No border checkpoint on this crossing to Russia. Just a burnt-out Russian tank. A different assignment for Ukrainian war reporter Natalia Nahorna. This is a historic moment, she tells the camera in the city of Sudja. Such a claim might be premature, but Ukraine is talking up this land grab while it can. It's providing humanitarian aid and organizing evacuations. There are even plans to set up military offices. But on the battlefield, success always comes at a cost, as this injured soldier attests.
Fear, adrenaline, you realize when you enter their territory how much we have suffered, how much our women and children have suffered. But now it's their turn.
The head of Ukraine's armed forces is having even more regular meetings with the president.
Since the beginning of today, troops have advanced around 1 to 2 kilometers in some directions.
After the body blow of losing territory, Russia is now moving resources to try and take it back. As fighter bombers drop glide bombs on Ukrainian forces on its own soil, Kyiv today claimed to have shot one of them down. The Su-34s are thought to be £30 million each. Kyiv is trying to change the politics of this war by shaking up the fighting itself. It's certainly done the latter. James Waterhouse, BBC News, Sumy region.
It feels like Ukraine's incursion is changing the equation and putting the Kremlin under pressure. A brief appearance today by President Putin, but no comment on the Ukrainian assault, which his troops are struggling to repel. The Russian military released these images, claiming to show it targeting Ukrainian troops in Kursk region. Moscow blames the West, too, for the incursion.
When I studied in the United States, the main rule was don't poke the bear. The West, what the West is doing today, they are poking the bear.
The public's sense of shock is growing. I feel incredible anxiety, Yulia says, as if my hands are tied, because there is nothing I can do about this. It's frightening to see the images of people panicking, Tatiana says, of people being evacuated. For some here, what is happening in southern Russia is a wake-up call.
Over the last 2.5 years, many Russians have tried not to notice what is happening, to get on with their lives, to pretend that there's no war. But with what's happening now in southern Russia, not noticing is no longer an option.
Especially here in Kursk. It's the air raid siren, she says. Get inside, fast. Ukrainian soldiers haven't reached this city, but no one here knows what lies ahead. Tens of thousands of Russians have fled the fighting in the border area. Some have taken refuge in Kursk. Vera left home in such a rush, she had no time to pack. I've nothing but the clothes on my back, she says. I'm looking for something warm. The Kremlin insists it will achieve its aims in this war. Russians are wondering when. Steve Rosenberg, BBC News, Moscow.